Hi from R Studio Transylvania. Merry Christmas to everyone. This is empty already, don't be worried. I'm in a kind of a big trouble right now. I forgot to buy my in-laws a nice present. So I invite you to stay with me and watch me while I'm gonna build them a nice little present. Bottle holder here made out of stainless steel. I hope they're gonna enjoy it. Therefore, you will watch me during the process of making this bottle holder. And I would like to start from the very beginning. This bottle holder here is made for a certain bottle of wine. My measurements are 310 mm long on my bottle. My diameter, the diameter of the bottle, 76 mm. Having this, I start from the very beginning, from scratch. I don't need more than that. My little bottle holder will be for 6 bottles, nice stainless steel in the kitchen, beautiful polished, my unconventional polishing, mirror polish, which I think I'm going to go for this time. So let's get started. I need 2 frames to build at the very beginning, these 2 frames. I need a couple of little feet here and on the back, a small little triangle I made that design, and a little hexagon in the middle. Couple of bits to catch all these little frames together. Therefore, I hope you're gonna like it and you guys gonna make one. Drop me a line if you want the measurements. If your bottles are the same like mine, you've seen the measurement of the bottle of wine. Can be adjusted, you can make it for a bottle of whiskey or anything you like. So, that's being said, let's get to work. I got my frames ready. I cut them off. I'm in a big trouble, that's why I didn't show you the cutting. I really need to get my hands on and finish it. It's 25th of December, first day of Christmas. I really need to get my hands on and do something about it. My in-laws won't be happy if I don't have it. So stay with me and watch me. We'll start with the frame at the very beginning. Like I said, I'll take the frames together, and as I showed you in some previous videos of mine, my little frames, I like them to be 45 degrees, nice cut. I have to say I use the cold saw because I don't have time to measure and catch it on the, it's a time wise, catch it on a vise and cut it with a grinder. So I used the cold saw in the shop. Honestly, it was much quicker. The problem is very big, so I had to think very fast and use the time I have in my hands. Being Christmas Day, not too much time available. Anyway, I got 4 little bits here, 45 degrees each. Like I said before, they give you a total of 90 degrees. Inside the frame, being a square, 360 degrees. I got my little dividers here, and I got this one to help me while I'm welding to keep the same distance so my bottle will sit in. When I'm gonna tack the frame, I'll use this one, I'll make the tack here, I'll move it down, I'll make another tack, and so on with all 3 gaps I got here. So I got something to help myself with to achieve the gaps. So the bottle will sit nice and beautiful, like you see in this one here. Just slides in and sits right there. I got a little help. I always like to use little pieces and bits and pieces to help me out, so I don't have to measure it. Okay, that's being said, I'm gonna get to work and I'm gonna set up my welder and start welding them. I just tagged my friend. Now it's time to check. It's time to check to see what I have done. My little bubble. It's just beautiful. Doesn't fall. Excellent. Check always. See if you've done the right job. As you can see, a room for three bottles, nice and beautiful. You can grab it, you can just take it out. Same like is that one over there. I will take the second frame. I'll do the welds, I'll do the polishing, then we do the assembly, putting together what you just seen over there. It's a nice little bottle holder, made out of stainless steel. You like to make it from some other materials, doesn't really matter. This is my frame. I use this to maintain the same gap in between the bits and pieces I tacked here. Nice and beautiful. It's good to have something to help you out always. Make your job easy so you don't have to measure it all the time. This is the way I work. Let's get the second frame done and we'll take it from there. Okay, so I've done my two little frames, which I said I'm going to tack for the bottles. Now I intend to do something as a decoration of my little stand, which will sit on the top here. It's a little hexagon. Now we've been talking about some geometry, how you're going to find the angles to cut these little bits right to give you the hexagon. Now, we've been talking about the sum of the angles in a polygon or a circle, it's 360 degrees. Divide 360 degrees by 6 gives you 60. To have the angle of your little bit you need to cut here, you need to divide 60 degrees by 2, which will give you 30 degrees. 30 degrees is very easy to cut on a console, even here if you like to cut it on your little shed. So these little bits here will have an angle of 30 degrees. You need six of them, will be a small little hexagon. I'll weld it on the top as a decoration or small little glass or a bottle to sit on an extra one. That being said, I got already my little hexagon cut. I'll start to tack together my little hexagon. From here I'll start putting together. I will work on this frame. They need to be welded, they need to be polished before I start actually putting together the rest of the feet, 3 feet, and finalize the little bottle holder I got here on the background. It's a good small little project. If you like it, you can do it. On my board I'll show you every single size. You can change them, as I said, based on your little bottle. Everything starts from the bottles you want to store. Do not forget, your bottle is very important, the measurements. This is my bottle, I got my measurements on the board. This is what I have right now. For you, if you want to change it, it's up to you. So let's get to work to do it quick.